And we are doing Night Towers today. And this is quite fitting, being as it is the 28th of October, and it's quite close to Halloween, because I think Halloween's on the 30th, if October even goes up to the 30th. Yeah, it goes to the 31st, so I think I don't know when Halloween is. Anyway, I just know it's in October, that's pretty much all I know. Anyway, if I had to describe this game in as few ways as possible, I would say Flappy Birds mixed with a hack and slash game, slash game. And bearing in mind this is the first time I'm even playing it, so I think I did pretty well, considering it wasn't the first time I played this. There are modes you can unlock and power ups you can unlock, which I show off later. I show off as best as I can't exactly spawn the power ups in. There's two ways to move. One, letting three monsters go by, you lose anything from that. Two, getting hit three times and losing all your hearts. You have to kill the monsters and dodge those pillars. And at the top of the centre you can see that's your progression bar. The more monsters you kill, the further that bar will get. And when you've filled up the bar, you will press onto the next level and when you do that bar, it will be set back to zero, so you don't have to be too it's not like game probably usually I think. And I do show off one of the unlockable modes later on in this, but yeah. This is one of those type of games where you're just like, oh, one more go, and then next thing you know, you've been playing it for over half an hour, and you guys can see that I actually let three monsters pass. And that's kind of a bit what happened to me here. Like, I did play it for a while, and I did keep going like, One more go. It's the only power-up. Well, it's the only power-up. So you have to unlock all of them. But yeah, you don't have to unlock all of them. All of them are unlockable. And, you know, but you don't have to. Anyway. Now, this is, in a pixel art style, which is quite common for the Nintendo Switch, really. And there's a reason for that. Nintendo Switch can handle it quite easily, and it looks really nice, in my opinion. It looks really nice. The pixel art is done quite well, and the only thing I can say about it is that I don't think we'd ever get like a sequel, because all the sequel could really do is probably just like retexture everything and just like Christmas. It's just like, unlike Paperboy, there's not really much. Video Kid. Unlike Video Kid, there's not really much you can do with just like the Beanie Nick, and you can probably make a bunch of Beanie stuff that you're probably not content for it to make a sequel. Probably like DLC later down the line when you can argue that the Video Kid. I suggest it would just be that DLC, but you could more reasonably argue a sequel for that, because it would take quite a while, so you'd basically be redoing the entire game, more or less, and that game has a lot more references, and it has twice, because as you can see here, it's usually the same two or three monsters that you see. A zombie, a flying troll, or a bat eye. Sometimes you see an alien spaceship mixed in there. And those will all be very good. Excuse me, might change the night itself. I don't think this will be then itself like a sequel. I could definitely see like DLC coming out for it, like, if they decide to do that. What I don't like about it, I played it with a GameCube controller, and it's all live with a GameCube controller, but in the like endless flight mode, you're probably going to be pressing Y instead of L to fly, because pressing L to fly and R to use sword, that starts this with your finger after a while, so you're probably going to be using Y for the endless flight mode, but for the most part I do like the I was using L to fly and A to attack. Other than that, I think you'd probably be using Y, like in the endless flight mode. I know all the modes like I do, and in the realize this at the beginning of the life one, I didn't realize that when you're viewing your scores and like how they rank up with everything else, you can actually go left and right, and it actually shows you the scores for the other modes as well, so it's all foils and modes before you even unlock them. That's probably like an oversight or something, you know, they probably didn't do that, but then this game is definitely like, I think this was one of the ones that was like 890 or something like that. I know it was really cheap. I don't think this was very much, right? And I would definitely suggest that it's like, this isn't like the best game of all time. It's not like going to be competing with like Mario or anything. Like, I don't think any of these really are, apart from maybe I don't think any of these really like competing for the best game of the year or anything. You know what I mean. But it's definitely worth picking up. In my opinion, it's 1 to 10. 1 being horrible and unplayable, 5 being okay, nothing special, and 10 being like the best game of all time. I give this a solid 6. About 6.5 maybe. Because it is a good solid game. It is a good game. And it is one of those games where you can just unlimitedly spend hours just like one more go. It's not like the best game ever, but it is a good game. And it is definitely enjoyable. I would definitely suggest picking it up if you like the sound of a Flappy Bird mixed with a hack and slash game. The gameplay is actually quite creative. For what it is like. Yeah. Anyway. enjoy the rest of the footage, because you know how I was saying how it's one of those games where you say one more time. Yeah, that kind of happened to me, and now I think I got about 26 minutes of footage, and my narration is only about 10 minutes in. So yeah, enjoy the rest of the footage, so you can see if this game looks like it to you, and near the end this will be I think that's a live mode, so yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow for another review, but I should be getting an actual short date, hopefully, that I can try to get it for a couple of days, but yeah, should be getting it today, so I might be doing a review of that later. And after that, I'll be doing playing normally because I'm doing a mini video on it after the review of the control. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.